of drawing Rodney Dangerfield as a vector drawing. So let's see if I can figure out where I left off here. We'll turn off the background of the face then, and turn the sample image back on. Let's see, probably just zoom in and pick up where I left off here. Hopefully I can not alter my style too much. Select the pen tool and just kind of come in here and draw some more shapes. Let's see. It might help if I get into a layer that's unlocked. That's why it's not drawing. Okay, here we go. And draw the highlights. This way. Just trying to outline the different shapes that I see here. Okay. That one I want to sample. Make that color. And I'm going to bring it down. Behind this other shape that I just drew. Turn that color back on, that's good. And let's do another sample here. Something like that. I think that's probably not too bad, actually. Oh, zoom out. I'll check my work a little bit, turn that background on that. Yeah, I'm going for kind of a cartoony look, so I think that'll work. Let's identify some more shapes to draw here. So just areas of color that seem to be about the same. Instead of turning that off, why don't we do my trick of converting it back to an outline? That way I can see some other shapes. So anything, yeah, we've got some shadow in here, don't we? So let's put that in. It's kind of comes down this way. Put those in the wrong layer. I wanted those up in layer 3. What's that one? Yeah, well, that's the one I want to leave alone. Let's just throw that up in the layer 3. Where'd it go? There. Move it down a ways. It's getting to be quite a big, a lot of curves on that one layer. If it gets too complicated, you can always start a new layer. But all right, it's a pen tool in here. Let's kind of go this way. I'm just kind of looking at this shape here, and it's all a kind of a judgment call, honestly. Just kind of looking at the shape here is, well, it stays kind of dark down this way. There we go. Come up here. Use the space bar if you need to move your image over. Gives you the hand tool and allows you to slide things around. Let's see. I think I went a little bit. That's not all the same. Same color, is it? I don't know if it's going to matter too much. It's just mostly a judgment call. Think. I think that's working. Is it perfect? No, I don't think it's gonna be perfect, but so I think it's kind of neat. All right, let's get some more shapes in here. There's kind of a shape here. Kind of goes this way. Roughly the same colors going on here. Sample that. Well, that's a little darker than I think. Yeah, it's more like it. Still have some shape here that needs to have some attention here. Let's go this way. marker. Let's get that shape that's missing there. Sample. I don't know, probably that's good. Now there's a really dark shape behind all of that that I want to not forget to do. And since it's going to go behind everything, I'm not going to worry too much about what it looks like in the areas that are going to be behind. So. So it's behind the shapes in front of it. It's a pretty dark shape in there. And looks like it's already behind. How about that? Okay. There's a little bitty gap in there, I noticed. Let's zoom in there a little bit. I think I'm just going to adjust that with my white arrow tool. Just kind of pull that up so it matches up to the curve there. I can do the same with there. Wow. Ooh, I forgot about that too. See, that puts curves on all the pointy edges. Undo. But there's still a little bitty gap in there. Didn't seem to want me to adjust it. There we go. Without moving everything. That's pretty good. I can check myself again by turning the photo off. See, there's still a gap in there. I moved that and I created a gap there. Well, let's just use that tool and that'll fix that. I think that's better. All right. Zoom back out. I mean, what will happen is instead of, it won't show up as white, it'll show up as that background color for the face that I created. This one right here. Is it selected? Oh, I see how those paths, I'm still drawing in the wrong one. I want to move those into the other layer. It might even be better to put those in a new layer. But yeah, see, that one popped up to the front. I used a keyboard shortcut there. There's a menu command where it goes send to back. So object, arrange, send to back. So if you learn these shortcuts like command bracket, command shift bracket, we can send them to back, send them to front with keyboard shortcuts. instead of using the menu. But okay, where did my face back path go? There, that selected it. And let's, there we go. That's what I was after. So, like, instead of white gaps in there, it's still that orangey pink, pinkish color, which is not too terrible. It's coming along, but I still wanna, I think I wanna turn that off a little bit. Come in here and do some more shape work. Let's see. He's got a mole here that's pretty distinctive. Let's make sure we draw that in. So, and let's get off of, let's get in the right layer. Layer 3 is where I want to draw this. And I want to, let's do the darker part first. I'll just draw it as an ellipse just for simplicity. And then if we do a, arrow key accidental movement, do a smaller ellipse inside of it with that highlight, and it probably needs to be squished a little bit and rotated even. Zoom in so I can get better control here. There we go. There's rotation. Sample that guy. More or less something like that. Stretch it a little bit. Turn that one back. There we go. All right. Okay, so we put these highlights in here too. Got some shadows, that's good. And there's some a little more shadow work, but maybe let's draw that in a little bit. So, switch that to line, please. There you go. That command shift left bracket to move it back behind everything. All right, we've got a little bit of highlight area in here. And it's just totally a judgment call. That, I mean, you could use software to set rules and have an algorithm do this, but what would be the fun in that? So I'm just picking where I think the shapes are. Your shapes may differ. There's definitely a shape edge right in there. But I'm just kind of picking areas that are mostly the same color. It kind of starts to change in there a little bit. This all seems to be about the same shape in here. Eyedropper that, it's a little darker. And then I'll do the command shift left bracket again to move it behind. A little darker shape in here yet. Eyedropper. Looks like there's even kind of a shape here that I ought to think about drawing. Down this way. And I don't know, something like that. Also kind of a shape in here. This is more or less the same shape all the way to here. It looks to me like there's kind of a little zigzag pattern there. Kind of even comes on up to here. There we go. Probably pretty close to the color I want, but we'll sample it anyway. Let's see. Zoom in here a little more. We spent all that time the other day drawing this, the other eye, that I should have drawn. Shouldn't have waited so long. Draw the other part of the eye, but we're just trying to draw the shape, so it should in theory continue to work. I don't know, I think this is kind of fun. It's a little monotonous, but I like the results you get when you put this kind of effort in. This is some really dark shape in here. It's kind of dark there too. I'll just make it all one shape. Another really dark piece in here. When you get to working, and the flow starts happening, you just truck along and you're not even really paying attention to what it is you're working on, except for just trying to identify the shape boundaries and draw those guys in. So yeah, I like drawing things that are in front, and then drawing behind. That's one thing that's quite different from in digital drawing, from working with physical paint or something like that, is you usually start at the bottom and work your way up. I don't know why, but I've just kind of created a habit of working in the opposite direction. I think I might have gone too far with that shape. So with this direct select tool, you can select points. So I'm holding the shift key down and just selecting all of them. You can also drag and select points. It gives me more control to just do them one point at a time, like so. What have I done here? Look at that. Let's see what happens when I delete. Yeah, I missed one there. Delete that too. Go back to the pen tool and close that shape up. Dropper, send it back. Okay. Now how's thing? Oh, still got a little bit of detail work in here, don't we? To work on. Quite a bit of that is not white. In fact, I bet that this white is not the same as this white over here. Yeah, see, that's quite a bit different. I think I can separate those with that eraser tool. Just like that. And now they've become separate shapes, so I can have another crack at setting the color. There we go. Send that back. Shape in here that's kind of pinkish reddish. I know that there's a couple of different colors in there, but we're going to just pick one and call it good. Okay. So with kind of see, yeah. See the edge of the iris. I think I'll just freehand draw that because it's not quite a perfect ellipse. Just follow the rule. The rule is just draw the shape, you see. So that's kind of what I'm doing. Even though it would kind of follow that the iris is a perfect ellipse. Ooh, something happened in here to make that go wonky on me. That's why a lot of times when I draw eyes, I do like to just use the ellipse tool and make it perfect. So I'll probably do that for the highlight and the pupil. So hold the shift key down and go like that. And same thing here. This is going to be more elliptical. Like that. And rotate it. Might make it a little bigger. I don't think it's got to follow perfectly. It's just kind of got to communicate that idea. Looks like there's another little highlight in there as well. But it's not quite as pronounced. Okay. Now, I'm just going to refer back to what I drew before. Okay, it's kind of spiky looking in the brown in there. And two shades of the iris. Okay, that's good to know. Go over here and no, maybe it is a little. There's a lot of different color in there, isn't there? So this is the white of the eye. It kind of, it's, we're gonna cover it up. So I think we're going to just sample one of these colors and go with it. Kind of like that. And then try to get that. So there's that star pattern and then another kind of star pattern in there too. So let's do kind of the brown. Like it kind of comes this way. It does not need to be perfect to be kind of a cartoon. What do we want? This lighter brown or the darker brown? I say maybe a mid, kind of try to get it in the middle. There we go. Like that. Then we'll do another kind of shape here to represent this other color. It's kind of a yellow green that I'm seeing when all that mixes together. Something like that. Alright, so it's dark brown. We've got that darkest blue there, so let's kind of go for this middle aqua kind of color. Oops, that went too far back. We want these guys to be all the way to the back, like so. I guess I'll switch that one first, and then that one. I don't know, there's a lot of red in there, isn't there? It's got these bloodshot eyes. Let's draw it. pinkish, orangish. There seems like there is some red over here also. Yeah, it's kind of all gray, isn't it? But there's a little bit of red in there, so let's draw it in. What the heck? It kind of comes up this way and a little bit up like that. Lost our gray piece in there. So one thing you can do, you can change your view to outlines and you can see where your lines all are. So I think that's the one. Go back to preview. Yeah. Send that guy clear to back. Alright. Now let's zoom way out and see how that's coming. I don't know. Turn that face off and turn that back on. Select. There we go. Finally, it was disabled. I don't know. I'm seeing. That's not terrible. I mean, it looks kind of shapey, but it's coming along. So let's select that guy. I'll leave it visible. That threw me for a loop that it was invisible. I'll just leave it as an outline for now. Okay. You did that. What else do we need to do shape-wise? Because otherwise, when that background's on, everything turns flat. So what color is that representing the most? I don't even know. I don't know where I took that sample from. Because this is much redder than up here, and this is brown. So we'll just continue. So there was a question, one of the questions to think about in class this week, and it was talking about adding more values. I believe if you have a greater number of values, what does that do to the appearance of the image, or the as far as depth goes? And as you can see, the more of these values we add, the more detail, the more depth that we add to the image. So I'm gonna, he's got a nice little crease across his forehead there. Let's zoom in even more. This kind of goes this way. Now I want to zoom out. There's a shape there. So the more of these shapes I add, the more detail it's going to be. No, I think we're getting pretty close to where I'll I'll be satisfied anyway, so let's go. Something like that. There's some more. This is kind of all the same color in here too, isn't it? I don't have much going on. I didn't finish this area. I didn't finish that, but I think we'll put this. That's a dark area there. Let's capture that. And then it's kind of a highlighty area in here. To me like this is pretty dark through here. I don't know, what do you think? I think that since that's open there, maybe we better do kind of a big shape behind all of that. Try to capture that color a little bit better. Kind of becomes sort of a mosaic. We haven't done anything with the hand here yet, so let's work on that shape a little bit. I think I'm going to start a new layer for that purpose. Always helps if you name your layers so you know what parts go where. This is more of a gradient, but I'm just going to suggest as much of these colors as I can without trying to draw every single one. Pick a middle of the road color there and continue. And I could do like I did with the face, just pick my base color to lay in behind everything and then draw the highlights and call it good. So I think that's what I'm gonna do here. So hold the shift key if I want it to go straight up and down, straight across. I'm going to just draw this behind that shadow I just drew. And I'll just send this clear to the back. All right. Pick it. So not the highlight, but a nice mid-range tone. That's probably good. Send that to back. Open it up again so I can see, and then now I just draw a highlight shape. Just kind of all of this. Whatever you see, kind of runs this away, going up into here a little bit. It's not perfect, but you see that hand starting to take shape. Oops. Undo. I just want this to not show there. Not show white. That highlight seems pretty bright to me. Does it to you? So I'm gonna bring the
expected.
I don't know. That's more like it. Turn that one too. And do the same thing. Just draw that finger in behind. Just kind of get the shape. Sampled the previous color, but maybe it's not quite the same. Yeah, we can probably work with that. Put some highlights in there. It goes down. Kind of a little shape here that I didn't draw on the other one. It'd be kind of nice to have this kind of shape. Some darker stuff going on in here. If I send this to that. Oh no, sometimes I worry it's gonna look weird, but it's a mosaic, it's a cartoon, so what if it looks a little weird? The main thing is just draw the shapes that you see. Kind of lost track of where I'm supposed to be here. shoot. Can't see my reference picture underneath, so I need to turn some of this stuff off. Okay. I think that's all right. Okay, we need some more shapes here. Let's see. We're gonna go with this. It's a little darker there. Now I could go in and draw all these individual dark spots in there. It just depends on how much detail you want to get, but I think I'm just going to suggest that stuff today. So, whoops. Let's get to the edge. Kind of go. That guy down like that. So that's that way, and then, like I said, we'll suggest some of this. Silver in there. Maybe I want to move this. That's the back color of the face. I'll move this up a little bit so it's behind all this stuff. Now I just got to figure out what to do with this remaining piece here. Like I said, I'm going to just suggest. It's not going to be perfect hair. Very cartoony at this point. And I think I'm going to just draw the simplest of shapes behind it here, and I believe I can grab the corners and manipulate that a little bit, but just make it be kind of a gray color like that. And I think if we zoom out, see everything, turn off the photo, turn on this background color. And I don't know what the photo has for, oh, we've got black that's way down in the bottom. And that's easily drawn with a rectangle. I'm gonna do that on the background, the bottommost layer. Just draw that in. Like so. And then send that to the back. And then up here I'll do the same thing, but we'll make that a gray color. And sample that, like the wall color. And send that to the back. There's a little patch missing over here, so we'll have that show up over there too. And that's pretty much what I'm after. Little tweak there and I think I'm gonna be happy. Hold that out, just come on. Yeah. Rodney Dangerfield. Zoom out. There you go. You can't even see the picture at this point, can you? You can see it moves. My square's not quite perfect down on the bottom, but that's the only piece I could see when I turned the picture on and off. Now it's all covered up, so that's the portrait. That's what I have. Thanks for watching.